We'll continue to look at ABBYY FlexiCapture's FlexiLayout Studio. Here we'll focus on the search areas in elements. So we'll talk about element properties, element search area descriptions, as well as element references. An element is a logical part of a FlexiLayout that is used to identify documents. We make it required to identify documents, or to actually find the rectangles that need to be OCR'd, or we can define elements to help us find other elements. So oftentimes those are keyword searches. So when we're building elements, we need to know where to search for an object, in other words, define the search area, and also it could be helpful to define the type of data we're looking for. A search area can be found via absolute coordinates or relations to other objects, which is a little bit more flexible. Absolute search areas are located using a measure rectangle tool in your toolbar. Essentially, you just draw an area. I'll use my pointer. Just draw an area such as this with the pointer tool, rather the measure rectangle tool, and FlexiCapture will apply that absolute area every time this document definition is matched. Now that can be deleterious if the form factor changes. If a document is sent sometimes in letter size and sometimes in legal size paper, or if the orientation changes from portrait to landscape, then absolute search areas will not be as useful. We can also use something called exclusions. So in an exclusion, we can define a string, such as address, and then we could define a paragraph, and we can exclude the element that shows where address is from the paragraph, so that when this gets verified or when it gets exported, we'll see Scotland Yard, Oak Lane 9, Staffordshire, UK, but we won't see the word address. That won't be exported. So this is a really, really powerful capability. Relative search areas. So we have the ability to say that something is nearest, we're looking for something nearest to something else. So we can imagine that this is a title to a document right here. And we could say these are three dates. This date here, this date here, and this date here. And what's important to remember is that when we're doing a nearest to function, the software is going to look from the nearest of the center of, say, this date to the nearest to the center of the title. Same thing here. And you can see the shortest line would be for the date E2. So that's how the nearest function works. And the nearest function can be very, very helpful when you're trying to reduce or eliminate branching. When we use relative search areas, we've got a more dynamic, flexible way of specifying where we're looking for our data. And it's best just to take a look at how this manifests. So we have a string, a keyword, credit note number. And here we're saying look to the right of the right boundary of credit note number. Here we're saying look to the right of the left boundary of credit note number. And you can combine relations. So look to the right of the left with an offset, look above the bottom and below the top with offsets. And you get a search area like this gray search area right here. So we, by default, when we create offset relations, there's zero, it's preset to a zero offset. So if we want to say look above the bottom of the word name with an offset of zero, we're getting this line right here. But if we say with an offset of 80, that search area goes right up here. That's a positive offset. A negative offset of zero, look above the bottom of the string name. But if we give it an offset of minus 80, the search area starts way down here. So a best practice is oftentimes setting an offset of minus 10 or 20 so that we're not tightly hugging the string that we want to OCR, and we can move it down just a little bit. We can add FlexiLayout language to help build complex search areas, really a number of things we can do in the advanced pre-search relations. And then in FlexiLayout language, we can write code that influences the choices FlexiLayout Studio makes as to what data to choose in the advanced post-search relations. So you can read more about that in ABBYY Help. So we talked about elements use, how they can be used to actually grab a rectangle or be used as a keyword to get in the proximity of our targeted data. And we can set search areas as absolute search areas or dynamic search areas based on relations to other elements. And we can use offsets to get the perfect search area. So we don't want to search in an area that's too tight. We want to give a little bit of wiggle room for degradation and image quality. And we can use FlexiLayout language to build complex search areas and to influence the choices we make once we have a search area in place.